Hey everybody, my name is Diana Loomer and I am here in my living room today in North Carolina with my timpani right next to the couch. I'm excited to talk to you today about melodic timpani playing. And you might not initially think of timpani as a melodic instrument because a lot of times you'll hear timpani parts like this. That's because originally, timpani were limited to just a few pitches, but with some mechanical developments and the invention of pedals, now we can change pitches on timpani basically as fast as you can move your feet. So I want to tell you all a funny story. Actually, the first melodic timpani playing that I ever did was by accident. I was in high school band class and everybody was playing Bach chorales as a warm-up. But there was no timpani part written, so I thought it would be fun to play the low brass parts, not realizing that this was kind of a weird thing to do. I also didn't have gauges on my timpani, so I had to do it all by ear and by using muscle memory with my feet. So I didn't realize it at the time, but those were actually really important fundamental skills for learning melodic timpani, and these really came in handy for one piece in particular. So in that same band class, we played The Inferno by Robert W. Smith. It's a really cool piece that has timpani featured throughout the whole thing, playing a bunch of solos that require 5 drums. But my band only had 4 drums in our set of timpani. So I actually had to pedal back and forth between the top 2 pitches very quickly during every solo in the piece. So that was the first time that I realized melodic timpani could actually be a really useful skill for logistical reasons. Learning melodic timpani is also great for ear training, building comfort with fast tuning changes, and it's much easier to do them when you're in a concert band piece or if you have to tune during a region band solo, for example. Another reason for learning melodic timpani, which I actually think is the most important one, is because it's really musically effective and interesting. Timpani are a really cool voice that have a huge range of expression. They can be beautiful and mellow, like at the beginning of the first piece that I played for you, and they can also be extremely powerful, like in this one. I think timpani should be used to their fullest potential, and if we have the capability of playing melodies on timpani, why wouldn't we? Believe it or not, melodic timpani may be even more common than you realize. For example, it's used a lot in film scores. Melodic timpani playing is also extremely popular in marching band and especially drum corps these days. So hopefully by now I've convinced you that melodic timpani is a useful and fun skill to learn. Don't be afraid of tuning timpani. Wind and string players tune their instruments all the time. Timpani actually work just like a string bass, but instead of having different strings, we have different drums. And instead of pressing your fingers up and down the string to change pitches, now we're just moving the pedals up and down. Timpani pedaling is a lot of fun. It just takes practice like any other instrument. And just like any other instrument, one of the best ways of learning the notes is by playing scales. Yes, believe it or not, you can play scales on timpani. I think that if you can play scales on timpani, then having four whole measures to do a couple of tuning changes in a timpani solo will be no problem. But before you can play your scales, you have to know what notes are available on each drum or the ranges of each drum. So here are the standard ranges that you should be able to find on any set of timpani. On some newer models of timpani, they might be extended a little bit past that range on either end, so you could go a little higher or a little lower. One interesting thing about timpani is that since the ranges overlap, you could actually have multiple options for where you could put your pitches. For example, D could go on my 29, 26, or 23 inch drums. I call this idea of deciding which drums to use for your series of pitches mapping. I usually like to pick the largest drum of my options because the pitches typically sound clearest in the mid to upper range of your drums. There are some other things to consider when choosing your mapping, like the fact that you probably only have 2 feet. So sometimes you have to consider how fast you can physically move between drums, meaning that you might be limited to pedaling on fewer drums. So if I play a scale spread out between 4 drums, the pitches could sound really nice and clear, but I can only move so fast because of having to move my feet over to a new pedal. But if I play the same scale on fewer drums, I don't have to move my feet back and forth between 2 drums, so I could potentially play the scale a little faster, just as fast as my feet can move. When playing melodic timpani, you should mostly rely on your ears for your pitch, but occasionally there are tuning passages that happen so quickly that you don't have time to quietly check your pitch before you have to play it. In this case, you could potentially use your gauges if you have them, and they'll actually help you to build your kinesthetic awareness for pedaling. But here's the thing, if you're going to use your gauges, you have to set them first. You can do this by using a tuner or a reference pitch and move each letter to where the gauge points when the pitch sounds in tune. And even if you have set your gauges, you should never assume that they are correct because they're probably not perfect. You should always be using your ears too. A good way to practice your pedaling and mapping, in addition to learning your scales, of course, is by playing familiar melodies. So for example, I could play Happy Birthday on timpani. One of the nice things about playing familiar melodies that you already know on timpani is that you get to focus on other things besides just the notes. For example, deciding where those pitches are going to go, on which drums, also deciding your mapping and pedaling system, focusing on things like when your foot moves, how fast it moves, is it a really clean tuning change, and just listening to the pitch of the drum and working on your intonation. So there are a lot of great skills that can come from this type of practice. So just like Happy Birthday, I could do the same thing with other familiar melodies, like songs from the radio. You could play along, maybe do some timpani karaoke.
When the night
So my challenge to you is this. Think of a song or a melody and try to figure out what pitches it uses. Then see if you can come up with some different options for where to put those pitches on the timpani in order to play the melody. See which of the options sounds the best. And if you're feeling extra creative, you could even come up with your own melody. Doesn't have to be something that exists already. So I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. Have fun and get those pedals movin'.